Hello everybody and welcome to another video. Today we'll be looking at a collection of machines that I currently own and explore some of the safety issues that they may have. Today we'll be checking the machines for thermal runaway protection as well as tinned wires on the terminals. I will be evaluating not only my FDM machines but also my SLA printers at the same time. As always, the information you see here represents my own opinions and no money has exchanged hands. After having watched the 3D Printing Nerds video on the CR30 along with Thomas Sandler's video on thermal runaway, I felt that expanding on this topic might be of use to some of you. You see, I've been using quite a few FDM and SLA printers non-stop and decided to show you guys just how many of my personal machines have issues out of the box. To start things off, I'll be looking at 3 of my FDM as well as 3 of my SLA printers for a total of 6 machines. These machines include the CR10V3, Ender 3V2, CR30, Anycubic Photon, VoxLab, Polaris, and Elegoo Saturn. Unfortunately, at the time of recording this video, my 2 Anycubic machines required maintenance, so I will not be including these in this video. It should also be noted that I had modded these 2 machines so extensively over the years that most of these issues have already been addressed. Let's begin with the machine that started this whole inquiry, which in this case is the CR30 by Creality. For the most part, this machine is very well thought out. However, I have had to do several adjustments after extensive use, and I'll be covering those issues in a future video. For today, however, I did check the machine for tinned wires. When I opened the machine, I did indeed discover that most of the wire connections to the terminals were all tin. I therefore replaced those with ferrules. The next machine was the Ender 3, and in this case, we once again have tinned wires at the terminal connections. After replacing those, I then started working on testing the thermal runaway for this machine. All 3 tests were successful, and indeed this machine did have properly implemented thermal runaway protection. Although error messages weren't always generated, the machine did on each occasion turn off the hot end. If you're testing your own machine, you'll want to keep in mind that the test for removing the connection to the heater cartridge does take a while longer depending on the machine. Let's take a look at the modified CR10V3, which does have an updated firmware which was created with the source code that Creality had on its website. When I recently went to check those files, I did find them harder to locate, however they are still available after doing some digging. Now similar to the Ender 3, the CR30 wires were tinned at the terminals and had to be updated to include ferrules. To do this, I used a ferrule crimping tool and automatic wire strippers, although you can use a pair of pliers to do the same thing. Now the wiring for the hot end is a little more complicated since it uses a hub to provide most of the power to the hot end components. Therefore, testing will most likely be more difficult if you're attempting this at home. This machine passed all the thermal runaways with the flying colors and had the appropriate warnings to pop up on each occasion. As mentioned previously, I was using my own modified stock firmware, which can be found on my website. Now all these FDM printers did have MOSFETs to help cool the motherboard, which is a very important feature to have. Since most of the power is being drawn to the hot end and the build plate, having those will help cool the connections and keep them from burning out. On my i3 Mega and Mega S, these were not present and I had to add them in separately. The Creality machines all have these built into the motherboards, and so long as they've been properly installed, they will help cooling the motherboard and prevent the wires from overheating. You can see that on my Anycubic, although the connections did overheat, the damage was contained to the MOSFET. In this case, the damage was caused because of the tin wires that were still present at the time. The SLA printers were all pretty surprising in themselves, with the Elegoo Saturn being the most complicated. Out of all these machines, all of them had tin wires at their terminals. Thermal runaway isn't an issue in this regard since we aren't dealing with a hot end or heated build plate. Out of all these machines, the most difficult one to check and repair is the Anycubic Photon since it requires the most awkward of disassemblies. While the Elegoo Saturn did take time to disassemble, all parts were fairly easily accessible, although you have multiple connections which are tinned. It's for this reason that I'll be releasing an additional video going over this in more detail for the Elegoo Saturn. In the end, the easiest printer to access all the components was the VoxLab Polaris. VoxLab opted to create a more open design, which should make upgrades or repairs easier in the future. So with all this information taken into account, how did all these machines do in the end? Well, none of these 3D printers had proper ferrule terminal connections, which is disappointing to say the least and should be very first thing that a user checks upon receiving their machine. Out of the FDM printers for Creality, all of them did have thermal runaway protection. The CR30 is still being tested as we speak, so you'll have to keep an eye out for that video when it comes out. Out of all these machines, only the Anycubic Photon was extremely difficult to access the internal components and is something that I would like to see them solve in the future. By far the easiest to disassemble was the Polaris, which clearly had a focus on repairability because of the open design. While the Ender 3 is still easy to open up, you do have to be careful when putting back on the panel. Since the CR10V3 has has a separate case for the electronics, repairs are easier since you can simply remove this portion. I hope this video illustrates how important it is to check your machines once you get them, since you never know how seriously a company has taken safety into account. As someone who has bought a device which didn't have thermal runaway enabled, I can say just how serious of an issue this could be, and just how thankful I am when it's properly implemented. In future, however, I would like to see companies stop using tin wires in their terminal connections, since this does represent a significant safety issue and is definitely something I will be watching for in the future. Also, for those of you who actually want to use this video as a guide, keep in mind that I will be posting a transcript on my main website to make it easier to follow along. Alternatively, please feel free to slow down the video by hitting the gear icon on the bottom right-hand corner of your screen to change the speed settings. If you want to support this channel, please feel free to check out some of the merch on my website. Thank you for watching, and I hope to see you guys soon. Thank you and take care.